Spokane, Washington, population 200,000, and the home of Gonzaga University. Gonzaga, with a student population of under 8,000, is known for their basketball program, which has been one of the most successful programs of the past two decades. They've made the NCAA tournament 21 consecutive years, dating back to 1999, with 10 of those appearances having the Bulldogs advance into the Sweet 16. Four of those appearances advancing into the Final Four, and one national championship appearance back in 2017, where they were beaten by North Carolina 71-65. Gonzaga's became a national powerhouse in college basketball, despite playing in a mid-major conference, and despite only having two top 30 recruiting classes in the past 20 years. With the trend of Gonzaga's basketball success, the national championship's definitely within reach. The only thing, this isn't basketball. Gonzaga used to actually have a football team 78 years ago in 1941. They actually had a pretty decent team too. From 1892 to 1941, the Bulldogs football team went 129-99, with one bowl appearance being a loss to West Virginia. Following the 1941 season, the Bulldogs football program went on a hiatus during World War II. But after the war, Gonzaga's administration decided not to renew the football program as Bulldogs football ceased to exist. That's until now. Gonzaga Bulldogs football, we're back. Gonzaga's Board of Trustees finally voted to bring the football program back to the university. And with the football program being so anticipated, it only took a year turnaround from the approval of the football program to Gonzaga going full FBS. And with the football program starting up so quickly, the first year of the program's existence, the team's roster will only consist of freshmen, which the recruiting class wasn't too great for Gonzaga, being the fact, you know, they haven't had a football program in 80 years, so not too many incoming freshmen took a huge shot in this program. Also, the team will consist of walk-ons, and the roster will also consist of senior graduate transfers from the five in-state football programs in the state of Washington below the FBS level. This includes the FCS powerhouse Eastern Washington, Division II Central Washington, and Division III Puget Sound and Pacific Lutheran University, as hopefully with the combination of incoming freshmen, walk-ons, and senior graduate transfers from in-state universities, we can field at least a competitive football program this first season for the return of Gonzaga football. And back when Gonzaga football existed, they only really had one rival, and that was Idaho. And with that being the case, I saw it only fitting that in this NCAA football 14 dynasty that we completely replaced Idaho, as they no longer exist here in this dynasty. And your Gonzaga Bulldogs head football coach, let's welcome Mr. Mark Herzlick to lead the return of this program. Mark Herzlick, a former standout at Boston College, also a leukemia survivor, came back after his battle with leukemia. It was actually named an All-American, picked up by the New York Giants, and served a decent amount of time in the National Football League. Former head coach of the Dublin Shamrocks, and since they ceased to exist, he decided to take on a new challenge here with the Gonzaga Bulldogs. As Gonzaga did play college football as an independent back when the program existed, we'll do the same with the program's return. And now after 80 years, it is finally time to meet your Gonzaga football team. At the quarterback position, our highest overall, 57 overall, Killian DaCosta, an incoming freshman, a little undersized at 5'9", 205 pounds. He's extremely stocky, and he can run the football with 81 speed. So he's somebody that is going to be fighting for the starting quarterback job. And the other candidate for the starting job, Ali Vanson, another incoming freshman, 6'9", 287 pounds. As Mr. Vanson is actually a walk-on himself, as he has not played football since his junior year of high school, as he attended Gonzaga with the hopes of walking onto the basketball program, didn't make the team, as now with the sudden return of Gonzaga football, is trying to return to the football field himself, along with being absolutely massive. He has 85 speed, 82 strength, 81 agility, and 94 break tackle at the quarterback position, but the problem is his throwing stats. He also has 75 trucking. His elusiveness is pretty low, but looking at his throwing stats, 84 throw power, which you would expect from a guy that's 6'9", but 52 throw accuracy, as that's what happens when you don't play football since your junior year of high school. As you see, DaCosta's stats at the quarterback position, 72 throw power, 69 throw accuracy, so it's a lot less throw power, but a lot more accurate. As we're going to have to see who's actually going to be our starter year one of the Gonzaga football program, as whoever starts here this first year might actually end up being a four-year starter here at Gonzaga, as the third option at quarterback is Leo Clancy. He's pretty much balanced. He's a lot slower than the other two, and I think to have a decent shot this year at competing, we're going to have a quarterback that can run with the football. Leo Clancy has okay throwing stats, but he's extremely slow at 54 speed. And our starting running back on this season, Mr. Dennis Merritt, one of the higher overall players on the entire team at 72 overall. He's the first grad transfer that you have met on the roster, as he does transfer over for his senior season from Eastern Washington, as he comes in at a 72 overall with 94 speed, 71 break tackle, 69 trucking, 76 elusiveness. He has 78 stiff arm. So he has some pretty decent stats. He's extremely fast. So hopefully he can help run the ball this season. As our backup, Callum Gonzalez, a walk-on at 6'4", 247. As he is going to be the big bruiser back there. As he has the size, he's massive, but he's just extremely slow. As Mr. Callum, one of the better walk-ons that we did find for the program, could help us out on the goal line. We have Darren Crowell, another walk-on at 5'9", 204, 61 overall. Brennan Clay, an incoming freshman at 5'9", 185, 61 overall. And Dominic Myron, another walk-on for your Gonzaga football team, but at a 58 overall. Hopefully, he won't get much playing time for us, because if he does, that means we're not doing too good. Our lone fullback, Christian Hills Sanders, another senior and another graduate transfer. This man transferring over from Central Washington University Division II squad, as he did play tight end at Central Washington, but for us, has converted to the fullback position. 56 overall, as he's just pretty much average across the board. Now, at the wide receiver position, we found ourselves the gem walking onto this Gonzaga program. Xander Van Halen, of German descent, at a 73 overall. He has perfect size at 6'3", 200 pounds. He's only a sophomore, so this walk-on is going to be able to play at least three seasons for us here at Gonzaga. Comes in at a 73 overall, tied for the highest rated player on the entire team, and he comes in as a walk-on with blazing 95 speed and 97 acceleration. He's also going to be our kick and punt returner for us here at Gonzaga. His receiving stats are a little subpar, but he should be able to make some plays this year with that blazing speed. Wide receiver number two, Mikey Langner. Another graduate transfer, this man coming over from Pacific Lutheran University, a Division III team in the state of Washington, coming in at a 64 overall. Although a lot of these players are coming in from Division III teams, with them being senior leaders on their former program, I think they should be able to provide some bit of spark for us this year, in our first year of the return of Gonzaga football. He's only a 64 overall, but he should be able to do something for us this year, at least be a senior leader for us. And in the slot, another Division III transfer, this man coming over from Puget Sound University, another D3 team, Ethan Goldison, at 5'7", 162, extremely undersized, as a lot of the D3 transfers are, but they are seniors, are experienced, so they should do a job for us. At 64 overall, he's not that fast, 87 acceleration, but he actually has some of the best route running on the entire team at 82, so hopefully can be a little productive for us. And our number four wide receiver, Tim Gauthier, a former teammate of Mickey Langner, as they both come over as graduate transfers from Pacific Lutheran University. He comes in at a 63 overall, so hopefully can be a little productive for us this season. As the problem is the fact three of our top four receivers are all graduate transfers. So yeah, we have a lot of graduate transfers on the roster, a total of 19. And each of those graduate transfers are starting for us. So that means we're going to lose a total of 19 starters next year. So even if this program is competitive this first season, this recruiting class is going to be easily the most important that this program will ever see. But our other receivers, John Jiggs, a walk-on junior at 61 overall. We have Samuel Shelton, another walk-on, 60 overall. We have Odell Rigsby, once again another walk-on, a junior at 59 overall. We have Dominique Bober, an incoming true freshman with great size, but he's just below average in his skills. He's 6'4", 200 pounds, but he's 57 overall. And the other walk-on, LaRon Davidson, a sophomore, 56 overall. Once again, hopefully won't see much of him in this series, because if we do, that means things are not going good for us. Starting tight end, Anthony Ruiz, another graduate transfer, and the first player we had transfer in from Whitworth University, another D3 program in the state of Washington, comes in at a 59 overall. He's extremely good at blocking, just not fast, but he will be able to help us out running the football. And our backup tight end, Corey Kispert. Corey is also a starter for the Gonzaga basketball program, which means he's obviously extremely athletic, but he also wanted a piece of the pie when it comes to the football program. So he's one of the three two-sport athletes on the roster, the only one coming over from the basketball program as well. So hopefully we can use his athleticism to our advantage this year. He's extremely fast, obviously great size being a basketball player, 6'7", 215, a little frail, but still can go up and make some catches. He's 57 overall, so he'll probably be the starter next year. And he also will get playing time behind Anthony Ruiz this year. The only problem with him is the fact that he cannot block whatsoever. His spec catch, his catch in traffic are great, his jumping is great. But when it comes to being a tight end, you need to be able to block at least a little bit. And as you see, he really can't block at all. With 56 pass blocking and 58 run blocking. Maybe we can utilize him, though, and his size on the goal line. And then we have an incoming freshman, Grant Galloway, at a 51 overall. Decent size, just not extremely talented. And moving on to the Bulldogs in the trenches, starting at left tackle, Chris Schlichting, a graduate transfer senior from Eastern Washington University. He was a three-year starter at Eastern Washington, and he comes in at a 73 overall, tied for the highest overall player on the entire team. 73 overall, this senior hopefully will protect the blind side of either Vincent or DaCosta at the quarterback position. Other tackles, walk-on Bill Walters at 58 overall, and incoming freshman Josiah Clifford at a 55 overall. Moving on to the left guard position, another graduate transfer, Alex Fairhurst, coming over from Pacific Lutheran University at a 58 overall, and backing him up, Marcus Kraft, another walk-on at a 51 overall. So many Division III transfers, but once again, guys, you think about it, they might be D3, but being so experienced and being starters for their respective programs for multiple years, they should be able to come and at least be competitive for us in our first year back in Division I football. At the center position, Ben Yusko, one of the three walk-on starters on the offensive line, the junior coming in at a 58 overall. And backing him up, another walk-on, Jimmy Berry at a 53 overall. At the right guard position, once again, another walk-on, Mookie Price, the sophomore, coming in at a 56 overall. Another guy who did try out for the basketball program, tried to walk on, didn't succeed. Never played football before, but he said, hey, I'm 6'5", 24, let me try football. He walked on, and he is going to start year one of the return of Gonzaga football. And backing him up, an incoming freshman, Mr. Mitch Berry, 6'4", 265. And at the right tackle position, and the last starter for your Gonzaga Bulldogs football team on offense, Rory Fogle, another walk-on, extremely undersized, but extremely technical. At 5'11", 298, not necessarily the size you want in a tackle, but he's the best option that we have. The junior coming in at a 57 overall. Backing him up, we have the walk-on sophomore, Ed DeLoach, 6'3", 303. It's a little bit too heavy, a little too unathletic, because hopefully maybe he can trim down a little bit and take over that starting job at the right tackle position. Last but not least, on the offense, Arnold Palmer, another walk-on. And once again, a little undersized as well at 6 foot. And he also at 51 overall. And now time to meet your Gonzaga Bulldog defense. At the left end position, Jim Townsend at a 69 overall, another graduate transfer, another player coming over from the Eastern Washington program. With Eastern Washington being such a powerhouse in the FCS level, hopefully a lot of their graduate transfers can be extremely productive for us in this first season, as Mr. Jim is actually extremely athletic for his size at 6'4", 265 pounds. He has 78 speed, 76 agility, and 75 acceleration. Hopefully he can get to the backfield a lot this season. Backing him up, another D3 graduate transfer, Brennan Fulkins coming over from Whitworth University, one of the higher overall D3 transfers that we do have. This senior is the backup left end, but he's actually going to play defensive tackle for us. He's a little bit undersized for the defensive tackle position, but he honestly is just the best option that we have. He has 55 speed, so he really won't be that great coming off the edge for us. I thought, why not go ahead and put him in at the deep tackle position? And last but not least, John Paul Payne, another walk-on at a 55 overall. Now at the right end position, we have another senior, another graduate transfer, Dwight Jackson coming over from Puget Sound. He's extremely undersized for the right end position at only 6 foot, 220 pounds, but he's once again the best option that we do have. He does have 75 speed, so hopefully he can get in the backfield. He's a converted linebacker from Puget Sound, so hopefully he can use that athleticism to get in the backfield. Backing him up, we have Douglas Bean, another walk-on at 59 overall. Last but not least, another walk-on, Malcolm Burnett, a junior at 57 overall. And one thing that I did realize, I know I haven't gone over the defensive tackle, but the fact of the matter is, we're going to have to replace every single defensive lineman going into year number two, as the left end, right end, and defensive tackle are all graduate transfers, all seniors that will be leaving the program after this first season. Moving on to the defensive tackle position, Deontay Novak. Keep in mind, Brennan Fulkins, the left-end graduate transfer from Whitworth, is going to start at defensive tackle. But the actual D-tackles that we do have, Deontay Novak, walk-on, 60 overall. Next, we have Jeremy Bowers, another walk-on, 58 overall. Ricky Reddick, once again, another walk-on, 56 overall. We have Calvin Pruitt, one of the only incoming freshmen that we do have on this entire defensive line, at a 56 overall. Last but not least, Nelson Seals, another walk-on, the defensive tackle position, 52 overall. So we actually only have a total of one incoming freshman on the defensive line. So it's all walk-ons and graduate transfers. So that's another position where you do have to recruit heavily in year number one. Now meeting your Gonzaga linebacker core. Starting at the left outside linebacker position, Carl Sowell, 63 overall walk-on, one of the best walk-ons that we do have on this team. Loved his athleticism with 78 speed, so hopefully he can run around the field this season, make some big plays. Backing him up, another very undersized walk-on. I mean, he's big in terms of his weight, but he's really short for a linebacker at 5'9". Trey Skinner, 61 overall. Rondale Miles, another walk-on, 59 overall. Last but not least, another incoming freshman, Anthony Jefferson, at 55 overall, and our fastest linebacker on the left side with 80 speed. Moving inside to our starting middle linebacker, and it's going to be the anchor of this defense, Jack Sindelbach, our starting middle linebacker. Another graduate transfer coming over from Eastern Washington, where he started 24 games. So he's a big member of that FCS powerhouse squad at EWU. And hopefully he'll do the same for us here in Gonzaga as he finally gets his taste for one season of FBS football. He has great size at 6'3", 225, 66 overall, 82 speed, 81 acceleration, so hopefully this man will be a menace for us. If I do remember correctly, yeah, he has huge hip power at 82, so hopefully he can force some fumbles for us this season. Backing him up, another walk-on, Gerard Owen, 60 overall, and then an incoming freshman with great size, Isaac Bowen, has just got to put some more meat on his frame. He's 6'4", 215, extremely fast, so hopefully we'll see him play a little bit later on in his career. Maybe even in his first season, since our roster is so thin. And our last starting linebacker, Tyrell Lake, a walk-on. And he probably is the walk-on that I'm most excited for. I mean, look at the combination of athleticism and speed. Another former basketball player couldn't quite make it on the Gonzaga football team. He's a junior. He's 6'6", 260, with 87 speed, 85 agility, and 88 acceleration. So this man should be running all over the field this year and making big plays for us. So I'm extremely excited about him. We're going to have 2 years to play with him. Backing him up, one of the best incoming freshmen that we do have in the entire program. The only three-star that did commit to us for our first year. Sergio Alford, 6 foot 213. 62 overall with 84 speed. Behind him, another incoming freshman, a two-star, Evan Briggs, 58 overall. Behind him, another walk-on just for depth, Quentin Hodges at 55 overall. Now, to the Gonzaga secondary. Starting cornerback, we have Tyson Prunty, another graduate transfer. This man also coming over from Eastern Washington at 69 overall can hopefully help manage that secondary. Number 2 cornerback, we have Jeremiah Vasquez, graduate transfer from Central Washington University at a 66 overall. Slot corner, we have Jason Clayton, another graduate transfer. He has great size at 6'2", 183. Maybe a little too light, but still at 6'2", has great length. 64 overall, graduate transfer from Puget Sound. And another graduate transfer at the cornerback position, Nathan Cooprider. He's also coming over from Puget Sound, so poor Puget Sound, Whitworth, and Pacific Lutheran. Three Division III programs in the state of Washington losing a lot of their core seniors for this upcoming season, but you can't blame them going all the way from Division III to FBS. You can't blame them for wanting a little taste of potential big-time college football. But behind Nathan Cooprider, we have Christian Aguero, an incoming freshman, one of the probably the freshman I'm most intrigued about. 6'4", 178 pounds, so great length at the cornerback position. He's only 59 overall, though. He's extremely fast, but hopefully he can develop with his technical skills with his 4 years here at Gonzaga. And last but not least, our sixth corner, Russell Hughes. Another walk-on with great size. I can say we do have relatively good size at the cornerback position this first year at Gonzaga. 6'3", 183, but at 59 overall, 93 speed, hopefully he can be a walk-on that can end up playing for us in his three remaining years here at Gonzaga. And cornerback's another position that we're going to heavily recruit because our top four corners are all going to be leaving after this first year. That's kind of the bittersweet part about having a lot of graduate transfers. Yeah, they'll help you out year number one, but they leave. They're basically like a rental. At free safety, no graduate transfers here. Marco Dryland, another walk-on. And it's crazy how lucky we got with all the walk-ons that we did get on this team when you consider their size. I mean, this guy is a 6'4", 209-pound free safety. Extremely fast with 92 speed, so he has the size, but the question is, does he have the technical ability? Maybe it's just the fact that we're from Washington and basketball is so big, and all these players want to play basketball, and when they can't play basketball, they turn to another sport in football. So I'm not complaining, just hopefully their size can actually speak volumes on the field and turn into productivity. Backing him up, we have another walk-on, Brock Gibbons, 63 overall, and behind him, an incoming freshman. Another incoming freshman with really good size, a two-star, Brock Rayner, at a 62 overall. So Brock is probably a player you're going to have to get used to, as he probably will play a total of 4 years here at Gonzaga. The highest overall walk-on in the entire program, Tavita Sharp, 69 overall, and backing him up, Quentin Powers, an incoming two-star freshman at a 55 overall. Now, for your kicker and punter positions, we have Frankie Jukovic at a 67 overall. He's a starter on the Gonzaga soccer team, and now he's one of the three two-sport athletes here at Gonzaga, a soccer player and a football player. We didn't want to waste a scholarship on a kicker, and he insisted, so why the heck not? At the punter position, one of Frankie's teammates, Demetrius Kaigea, another Bulldog soccer player, coming in at a 69 overall. He's a little short at 5'7", 172, but still should do a job with this. And coming in at 95 speed and 92 excel, this man should definitely be able to help out making tackles out on the field when he punts the football, which will hopefully not be a lot. Hopefully we will be scoring a lot, not having a punt. But with this being year number one and the players sucking so bad, he probably is going to see a lot of the field. But we are going to have Frankie and we are going to have Demetrius at our kicker and punter positions for the next 3 years. So at least we don't have to worry about wasting a scholarship on those two positions for a while. So that is your Gonzaga Bulldogs starting roster. We have only three players over 70 overall. I mean, truth be told, I actually really do like this squad. The only problem is, like I said, I mean, we have a ton of experienced players coming over from FCS and below level colleges in the state of Washington. A lot of grad transfers, so that's a lot of experience, a lot of older players. But once again, the problem is the fact that we're going to have to replace those players after year number one with incoming freshmen. So as I said, the recruiting class for year number one is easily going to be the most important that you'll ever see here in this series. I'm just most intrigued about this quarterback position. Do we go with the better thrower who can still run the football? He's undersized, Killian DaCosta. Or do we go with the absolute physical freak and Ali Vanson, who's 6'9", with 94 break tackle, but he can't accurately throw the football? Maybe we split time between the two quarterbacks in the first few weeks, and then we name a starter? I don't know what to do. But now time to check out your Gonzaga schedule. For year number one, we signed a lot of home-and-home deals, and look at it. as a lot of the major basketball programs across the NCAA couldn't help themselves in scheduling a home-and-home immediately with Gonzaga, as they knew the potential for a huge hyped-up matchup had too much potential to turn down. And the four universities that we did schedule a home-and-home series with for the first 2 years are Duke, North Carolina, Kansas, and Kentucky. We play at Duke and at North Carolina next year. We'll play against them at home. Against Kansas, we'll have to travel to Lawrence in year number two. We'll have to travel to Kentucky in year number two. And BYU is currently Gonzaga's biggest rival in terms of college basketball. So it's going to be the same for college football, as we will be playing BYU each and every season. As with this being year one of the football program, the schedule is definitely not too easy. So if we win more than two games this first year, I'll be shocked. As we start this season out with three consecutive away games at Duke, at North Carolina, at BYU, as we play our first game at home in the return of Gonzaga football in over 80 years against Kansas. Then at UCF, home against the reigning college basketball national champions in Virginia. And we finally get a bye week here, which is much needed in week number 7. Then we play four more consecutive home games, home against Kentucky, home against Western Kentucky, home against FCS East, as we probably need a little cool off here before we end off the season with three huge matchups. Home against Syracuse, at LSU, and then at Notre Dame to end the year. So season number one is going to be extremely difficult. As like I said, I mean, if we win two games, I wouldn't be way too mad at it. With the team consisting of incoming freshmen, walk-ons, and graduate transfers from mainly Division III teams? I mean, it's going to be extremely hard to compete with a lot of these teams, especially the LSUs and Notre Dames. I mean, even I feel like we could get blown out by UCF. I mean, seriously, you probably could, like, get blown out by each and every one of these programs. The two games that I am eyeing for hopeful wins this season are Western Kentucky and against FCS. And, I mean, that's not even a guarantee at all. I do think it is important for the future of this program to redshirt as many of the players as we possibly can so we can have them for a few extra years moving forward. At the quarterback position, no options there. Running back position, no option there. Oh man, what do we even do here? Might as well go ahead and redshirt Odell Rigsby and Dominique Bober so we can have them for a few extra years. We might as well go ahead. Do we go ahead? John Jiggs? Why not? We'll redshirt John Jiggs as well. So we only have six active wide receivers this first season, but if worst comes to worst, we can burn one of these red shirts. All right, tight end, we're not going to redshirt anybody. Might as well go ahead and redshirt a couple of the offensive linemen. Jimmy Berry, we can redshirt him. Right guard Mitch Berry, redshirt him. And at right tackle, Ed DeLoach, we'll go ahead and redshirt him as well. Defense, I think we're going to give a redshirt to John Paul Payne at 55 overall. He's really not going to play for us this year. Defensive tackle, we can redshirt both these guys, Ricky Reddick and Calvin Pruitt. The linebacker core have a ton of linebackers that we can redshirt. Rondell Miles and Anthony Jefferson. Middle linebacker, ooh, it's a tough one. We'll go ahead. We'll redshirt Isaac Bowen. I know he's 6'4". I do want him to play, but I have to be smart for the future and redshirt him so we can get him for an extra year later. We'll redshirt Evan Briggs and Quentin Hodges. I think Sergio Alford will get some playing time this season, so we'll save our redshirt on him. And the cornerback position, oh my god, dude. We'll go ahead. I'll go ahead and redshirt one of these guys. We'll do Christian Aguero. We'll go ahead and redshirt him. I know Brock Rainer, he's a guy that could contribute this first season, but for the future of the program, we will go ahead and redshirt him. At strong safety, we have no depth here, so I'll keep Quentin Powers on the field, although he's a 55 overall. And we're good at kicker and punter. So a lot of red shirts, but it's for the best. Now it's time to check out our first ever recruiting board here at Gonzaga, as I do fully expect to sign the full 25 players this season, as our recruiting board is pretty much all over the place. Number one on our board, Frank Givens, a 3-star. We opened the year number 6 on his top 10. Hopefully we can end the year as his number 1, because with him being a 71 overall, he'd immediately start for us. Number 2 on our board, Avery Bowie. He's the only player on our board who does not have us in his top 10. And the reason being is because he is the fastest player in the country. I mean, I'm trying to create California as a pipeline state, so I need to try and sign as many players as I possibly can from California. And he is one of the few 4-stars that we do have on our board. Hopefully he is a guy that we can steal from the likes of UCLA, USC, Stanford, and Cal. Next on our board, a JUCO wide receiver in Steven Anderson, fifth on his top 10. He's a two-star. With him being a JUCO, he's going to be probably over a 70 overall. With most of our wide receivers being seniors, we need some talent immediately coming in next year, so hopefully we can land him. So I lied. This is the second and final player that we are not in their top 10. As the reason he's on our board is because he's the number one player in the state of Washington. And I want to try my best to keep the best talent in the state of Washington in its state. I want to show Washington who's going to end up running this state in college football. Ron Thompson, the number one quarterback on our board. And not only that, we already lead for him. So hopefully we can get this three-star from the state of California. Good size at 6'5", 216, this three-star. Hopefully he can be our starting quarterback in the years to come. Number 6, Jonathan Wilson, a big-time free safety, 3-star, 70 overall, 3 on his board. He had to overtake Washington and USC, but hopefully they'll focus more on some 4 and 5 stars so we can grab him. Number 7, a big defensive end in Tyree Williams, the 3-star from Atlanta, Georgia. Number 3 on his board behind Ohio State and Texas. But, I mean, pretty much if he came in year 1, he'd be able to start immediately, because most of our defensive linemen are freaking seniors and walk-ons. Next, Mr. Chad James from the state of California. We're number 8 on his board. A big-time strong safety, good size at 6'2". Hopefully can land him. Darren Todd, another strong safety. This man a JUCO. We're already number 1 on his board, so hopefully we can sign him. And more than likely, he'd play immediately. Another huge defensive end, literally. 6'5", 270, Mr. Anthony Mitchell from San Francisco. We already lead for him, so hopefully we can close the deal and sign him to the program. As another wide receiver here, as hopefully I can sign like 3 or 4 this year. Jimmy Burgess at a 67 overall. He has great size at 6'3", 191. He's pretty fast as well. He's an in-state player. As you see, the other big-time in-state programs lead for him. So hopefully we can overtake them and once again show Washington and Washington State who runs this state. Next, Mr. Joey Hill, another 3-star player. Another 3-star cornerback with good size at 6'1". We already lead for him, so hopefully we can fend off Hawaii and close the deal with him. First running back you have seen on the board, Josh Bryant. A power running back, a 3-star, looks to be a 68 overall, number 6 on his board. Because running back is important because our number 1 running back, Dennis Merritt, is going to leave after this year. So we do need to sign at least one or maybe two running backs. Another quarterback on the board, Russell Lawrence. No relation to Trevor Lawrence, because this man's from Honolulu, Hawaii. He's a scrambler, 6'1", 206. And I would not be opposed to maybe signing two quarterbacks in this first class. Next, the big-time middle linebacker, Josh Sullivan, who could come in and play next year. As our starting middle linebacker, once again, is another graduate transfer who's going to be gone. We already lead for him, and hopefully that doesn't change. Our first offensive lineman we've seen thus far, as we do need to sign a couple this first year, Josh Dinman, another 3-star that we do lead for in-state. Washington's creeping up there, as is Washington State. We're going to fend them off as the Bulldogs are going to get this one done. He's once again a little undersized for the center position, but we need pretty much anybody we can get at this point. Next, we have Antoine Smith, the lone tight end on our board, coming in at a 68 overall. He's a little small, 6'1", 219, but he can block well, as we're going to need a blocking tight end after Anthony Ruiz graduates after this first year. We're right behind North Carolina. Hopefully we can snag our one and only player that we're targeting from the state of Tennessee. Another solid wide receiver target, Nigel Jackson, a 3-star from San Bruno, California. We're a little bit behind USC, but USC is going to end up going for the 4 and 5 stars, so I think we have a good chance for him. Another athlete, David Fry, a 3-star from Ohio. Another cornerback in Sean Williams, just like the wide receiver position. We need like 3 or 4 corners in this class. He's a 3-star from California. Hopefully we can gain some ground on Hawaii and take over for Mr. Sean. Another wide receiver, and this guy is extremely intriguing. Ryan Mosley from the state of Georgia. We're already number 4 on his board. He's 6'6", 209 pounds. So his arms might be like 14 inches, but who cares when you have the size at 6'6". Hey Ryan, if you want to have a recruiting pitch, you can play basketball for us if you wanted to. Another cornerback in Cedric Everett, 3-star from Texas, 65 points behind Syracuse. And as you will notice, I probably won't go over these players. The last like 10 or so players on the board are a little bit lower in overall, but a lot of these players that we do lead for. So just in case we need to fill some depth at certain positions, we can sign a couple of these guys a little bit easier than some of the other guys. So they are on the board just in case, but they are kind of like a second option. That's not good. Already the first guy we scouted, number 1 on our board, Frank Givens, already dropped down 3 overall. JUCO Steven Anderson looks really good up to a 72 overall. Jason Pierce, the athlete, already down to a 72, but he has 95 route running. His catching sucks, but at least he can run routes effectively like a young Wes Welker. Now this is a big one. Mr. Ron Thompson could be our new starting quarterback next year, depending on how our starters play this year. He comes in 73 overall. This man could be a gin for us. 83 throw accuracy. That's like 15 better than anybody else we have currently on the squad. So this tight end, Mr. Antoine Smith, he looks like he's going to be a gym as well, up to a 72 overall. He has 73 run blocking. So maybe he's a guy I need to key on a little bit more and hopefully overtake North Carolina. So you didn't notice anything too crazy from the other guys that I did scout, but I will keep you guys in the loop if we do find any gyms or find any bust on our board. We do have a few upgrades here for head coach Mark Kurzlick. Do we go game management or recruiting? I think recruiting is more important at this point in time. I think we're going to go with the scouting upgrade on recruiting. Next, we have our DC, Mr. Matt Henry. Upgrade our power move and finesse move. And our OC, Mr. Patrick Blanchard. What are we going to do here? +2 to injury and +10 in stamina. Nah, we'll do the carry. We don't need a fumble this year. So up the ball security. And guys, with that, I think that does it for episode number 1 of the return for Gonzaga football. So hopefully guys are excited, as we will go ahead and start the season. And if we can smash 2,000 likes in this first episode, the regular season will begin tomorrow against Duke. So make sure to smash that like button and subscribe if you are new. Turn on the notification bell if you haven't. I will catch you guys next time. Have a great rest of your day. God bless and peace.